अज्ञान तिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय सदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा, नमो भक्ति विनोदाय सच्चिदानंद नामने गौर शक्ति स्वरूपाय रूपानुगामराय थी। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु सेस, द नेम ऑफ कृष्णा रिमूव्स ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ डिस्ट्रेस एंड सॉरो फॉर दोज हु हैव टेकन शेल्टर ऑफ हिम। वी हर्ड अबाउट दिस, वी हर्ड यस्टरडे अबाउट दिस। He especially removes the Brajavasi's extreme pain of separation. So the name of Krishna, which is superior than Krishna, not only taking care of the distress and sorrow of people in Jarna, but also Krishna Naam is the only way to remove the Brajavasi's extreme pain of separation. In the absence of Krishna, when he went to Mathura and Dwarika, then it's Krishna Naam which saved the Brajavasis. Brajajana Palan Asurakul Nashan. Brajajana Palan, he is taking care of Brajavasis, he is nourishing Brajavasis. How? By giving them pain. Yes? By giving them distress. No, by giving them bliss, by giving them an opportunity to remember him more and more, because he is the source of bliss. No? The Brajavasi's extreme pain of separation. In the absence of Krishna, they used to chant the names of Krishna. Nanda Nandana Yashoda Jeevana Heshi Madhava. I forgot this. The names of Krishna. So who is powerful and who never leaves us, who never leave Brajavasis, is the name of Krishna. Krishna left for some purpose, but Krishna name, the Krishna Naam, always stays with Brajavasis. Shridham, Subal, Madhumangal, imagine, every day they used to play with each other, laughing, joking, climbing on each other's shoulder, eating together. And Krishna left Braj and he went to Dwarika. Imagine. Just we can imagine this. What kind of separation the sakhas, the friends were feeling in the absence of Krishna. Taking cows for grazing, and wherever they were looking, reminds them of Krishna. The bank of Jamuna, where they were eating together, those trees where they were jumping, taking the fruits, all those spots where Krishna killed demons, Talwan, and then other forests. So how they were spending their days in separation from Krishna. How Yashoda Maiya and Nanda Baba, they're spending their days, their time in absence of Krishna, only by taking shelter of Krishna Naam. And then Braj Gopis, they used to have so friendly, intimate relationship with Krishna. In the absence of Krishna, the memories of Krishna, and all those places of pastime, Mansi Ganga, where they used to have boat festival, Nauka Vihar, and then Govardhan, all those caves, all those kunjas at Nidhivan, Seva Kunj, Shingarbhat, where Krishna used to decorate Radharani's hairs. Now in the absence of Krishna, how they are spending their time? Mahaprabhu said, Yugaitam Nimeshena Chakshusha Pravashitam Shunyaita Jagam Sarvam Govinda Virahinami. Yugaitam Nimeshena. One eleventh part of the second appears to Gopi says, the yugas, the ages have passed. Shunyetam jagat sarvam. The whole world now looks empty in the absence of Krishna. Govinda virahnami, in the separation from Krishna. So who saved them? Who protected them? Krishna Naam. There can be union and separation with Krishna, but there is no separation from the Krishna Naam. Krishna can tell lies and go, but Krishna Naam cannot go. So who is more powerful? Something which is more powerful than Krishna is Krishna Naam. That's why Mahaprabhu said, Golokera Premadan. What to speak of the residents of Raj? Even the cows, the monkeys, the rabbits, peacock, parrots, all birds, they used to chant the glories of Krishna. Shuka Sari Samvad, the parrot, peacock, all crying and weeping. And that's why there is bhajan which Gurudev used to like and ask devotees to sing in Mathura, in Vrindavan. Manaro lage na sakhiri mero sham bina, manaro lage na sham bina, ghan sham bina, manaro lage na, manaro lage na sakhiri mero sham bina, manaro lage na. Suni suni lage mori braj ki gali, kunja na suno lage sham bina, manaro lage na. ग्वाल बाल सब तड़प रहे हैं। अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग? विदाउट श्याम, विदाउट कृष्णा, एवरीथिंग लुक्स एम्प्टी। द गोपीज आर एड्रेसिंग टू ईच अदर, विदाउट श्याम, विदाउट कृष्णा, एवरीथिंग इज सो एम्प्टी। No, relatives are there, Jamuna is there, Govardhan is there, everything is there. The sakhis, the friends are there, but still everything is empty because Krishna is not there. The object of love is not there. The object of prem, Krishna, is not there. Then everything is empty. So, ग्वाल बाल सब तड़प रहे। गोपी सिंह, ऑल दो सखास, दे आर सो रेस्टलेस, दे आर बर्निंग इन द फायर ऑफ सेपरेशन। काउस नॉट ग्रेजिंग ग्रास एनी मोर, the calves not drinking the milk of cows. I'm trying to remember that. Anyway, so they are discussing with each other. That the song Gurudev used to hear. It's all about Brahmar Geet from Bhagavatam. In the separation of Krishna, this is the condition. The trees in separation from Krishna. No leaves, no fruits, no flowers on the trees. And this is what Uddhavji saw when Krishna inspired Uddhav. Go to Braj and pacify my Brajvasis. What Uddhavji saw there? Everything. First of all, he saw everything in a good shape. Birds are chirping, bull are fighting. It's mentioned in the commentaries. Two bull fighting to get a cow. What is the significance of this? That means everything is very normal. Two bull fighting for a cow. Everyone is running here and there to milk cows, to take care of the fields, and it's all this. But just after a moment, Krishna covered that scene. And immediately Uddhav saw the other scene. That was quite shocking for him. Seeing the other scene, and he saw what we just saying. No leaves, no fruits, birds sitting on trees just crying, tears falling on the ground. Trees are crying. Imagine. Cows, the cowherd boys, the elderly gopas, they're forcing cow with a stick in their hand to eat grass. Cow, they don't want to eat grass. Cow never leave grass. They're always looking for green grass. But now they're getting forced to eat. They don't want to eat. Calves, they don't want to drink milk. Calves always running to the udders to drink milk. But now calf is not drinking milk anymore. Yashoda, Maya, Nanda Baba crying. Uddhavji asked a local resident there, which way to go to the palace of Nanda Maharaj? And they said, oh, just follow this drain. Where this drain ends, that's the palace of Nanda Maharaj. And Uddhavji was wondering, what is the details, significance of this dream. They said, oh, I think you are new here. He said, yes, I'm from Mathura. They said, since Krishna left, Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda Maya, Roni Maya, and all other gopis, the friends of Yashoda Maya, they always crying and weep. And with the tears, so much tears, flowing like a drain, like a stream of tears. And Uddhavji is wondering, what is this? Why so much crying? And what is this separation about? Uddhavji knows the complete sweetness of Krishna. He knows the complete opulence of Krishna. He knows the pastimes of Krishna. But he's not understanding, what is this? And on the top of that, when Uddhavji saw the condition of Radharani, he was so much shocked. What is that? So, when even Radharani was in that state of unconsciousness and she can't even move, and the Sakhis were trying to check if she's breathing or not, putting a cotton ball on her nose, if this cotton ball is moving or not. How Radharani was surviving? By the name of Krishna. Vishakha Sakhi chanting the names of Krishna in the ears of Radharani. That's why she was able to survive. She was chanting Krishna, 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 Krishna. So, what to speak of? The name of Krishna removes the kinds of distress and sorrow of those who have taken shelter of him. He especially removes the Brajavasi's extreme pain of separation. Imagine how powerful is Krishna Nam. More than Krishna. Krishna Nam sports as Nanda Nandan Shri Krishna. Krishna Nam dance on the tongue of pure devotee. Sports as Nanda Nandan Shri Krishna, the personification of supremely delightful, condensed, transcendental happiness. That's the nature of Krishna, the personification of delight, condensed, transcendental happiness. The holy name is the great festival of Nanda Gokul. Nam Gokul Mohasav Te Krishna Poon Vapushu Namo Namaha. This is what we were. Poon Vapushu. Yeah. Nam Gokul Mohasav Te Krishna Poon Vapushu Namo Namaha. The meaning is, the holy name is the great festival of Nanda Gokul. Festival not in the time of union, but also the times of separation. It's not that. Don't think this otherwise, that only in the separation Krishna Nam, the name Krishna was taking care of Brajavasis, but even in the presence of Krishna, Brajavasis were taking shelter of Krishna Nam, giving them joy and bliss. So, please let me attain undivided love for Shri Krishna Nam. He's showing us how to pray. Please let me attain undivided love. The love which is not divided. That means one-pointed love for Shri Krishna Nam. That much gravity is there in Krishna Nam. That much important is Krishna Nam. Aho! Exclamation. Aho! All anarthas will be completely destroyed through Krishna Nam Sankirtan. What we need more than that? All anarthas which is so difficult to give up. Hide Durvalyam, Asat Krishna, Swarup Brahm, all this from this lifetime, from previous lifetime. Even prarabdhas can be. The prarabdhas cannot be destroyed. But in Naam Ashtakam by Rupa Goswami, in the song book, you will find a verse where Rupa Goswami is writing that all glories to Hari Naam, the Krishna Naam, which can even destroy the prarabdha. The best means of all atonement, the best means of having proximity with Krishna, the best means to attain any goal of life. And without Krishna Naam, no yajna is complete. Even samarthas, samart brahmins, when they do yajna, they have to utter the name of Krishna. Om pavitram pavitrova. They purify themselves in the beginning, chanting this, Pundrikakshaha, the name of Krishna. Om Tad Vishnu Paramam Padam, the name of Krishna. So no yajna is successful without Krishna Naam. How important in each and every step. For the sadhakas, anarthas are the most worst obstacles and hurdles in attaining one's goal. We are full of anarthas. We are full of mistakes. But by taking shelter of Krishna Naam, all anarthas can be destroyed. I am not saying this. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying this. And not only the anarthas destroyed, and all varieties of auspiciousness as well as joyful love for Krishna will arise. Not one or two, but all varieties of auspiciousness as well as joyful love for Krishna. That's the best benediction. Joyful love for Krishna means the prem seva for Krishna will arise. A question may arise here. The holy name is able to destroy the 32 kinds of seva prad. But how can criticism of devotees and saintly persons, means sadhu ninda, and the other 9 kinds of nama prad be destroyed? The question has been raised. Seva prad. 32 kinds of seva prad. Sitting in front of the deities with extended legs, seva prad. Come in front of the deities with impure state, seva prad. Shouting in front of deities, seva prad. So there are many. Touching deities with left hand, seva prad. Being lazy in serving deities, seva prad. So there are so many seva prads, 32 kinds. But you can find this in Jaiva Dharma and Bhakti Swami Sindhu, Bhakti Swami Sindhu Bindu, in all these books. In Sindhu Bindu, you will find this. But how can the criticism of devotees, sadhu ninda, and other 9 kinds of nam aparad be destroyed? How many kind of nam aparad? 10. First one is satang nindam, the criticism of sadhus. How this can be destroyed? The answer is that they can also be destroyed by chanting Harinam. Mahaprabhu is speaking with this note. Understand? The path of Ashtanga Yoga is always full of fear. Srimad Bhagavatam says, the mind that is disturbed, Yamadibir Yoga Patehe, Kama Loba Hatomuhu, Mukunda Sevya Yadvat, Tatha Atmadha Nas Shamayati. The mind that is disturbed by the enemies of lust, anger, greed, and so forth, does not become subdued or peaceful by practicing yam and niyam on the path of Ashtanga Yoga, as it does by performing service to Sri Mukunda, which completely controls it. Yeah. The enemies, where is our enemies? Everyone has some enemies. I mean, not everyone, but many people have enemies. But the worst enemies is with us, in our body. They are lust, anger, greed, envious, illusion, enviousness. They are the worst enemies. So, and they cannot be subdued by practicing yam and niyam of Ashtanga Yoga. For that, we need something very strong weapon. And the strong weapon is the service to Mukunda. Big Y, Mukunda. Mukti tadati iti Mukunda. Who can give Mukti? Only Bhagwan Mukunda can give Mukti. Mukti dadati iti Mukunda. Mukti means liberation. But liberation from lust, anger, greed, that's also important. So we want mukti from lust, anger, greed. Devotees, they don't want liberation at all. But we really want mukti from. Understand mukti? I want get rid of this. I want liberation of this. This lust, this anger, this greed always troubling me. I'm getting punished by them. Please. How it can be subdued? By serving Bhagwan Mukunda. That's the process. Gradually, gradually, gradually. Jat Shadho Matkathasu Nirvin Sarva Karmashu Ved Dukhatma Kama Parityago Apnishvaraha Tato Bhajate Mam Shradhalu Dhida Nishchaya. Krishna Singh Shrimad Bhagavatam 11 Canto. Jat Shadho Matkathasu. One who has developed faith in my katha, in my pastimes. Nirvin Sarva Karmeshu. And gave up all other prescribed duties. Ved Dukhatma Kaman. Lust, anger, greed, troubling. And one get engrossed in that. But with a heavy heart and with a repentance mood. Tato bhajate mam. Still he's not giving up. And keep on chanting and hearing and serving. Shraddhalu dhida nishchaya. With firm faith, fixed determination, and with shraddhalu, yeah. Dhira nishchaya, with firm conviction. Jushmana chathaman. Very soon, with this repentance mood and continuously chanting Bhagavan Mukunda in the form of taking shelter of Harinam, holy name, he will overcome or she will overcome all these enemies of the mind. How? Only by Krishna Nam. We are trying our best. But there is a need to try for this. If we don't even try and just become lazy thinking, oh, whenever it will happen. Not like that. Utsah nischa dhairya tat tat karma parvartanat sanga tyago sato vritti shadbhir bhakti prasiddhati. Utsah, enthusiasm, nischa, conviction, dhairya and patience. Three things goes together. Patience also required. Enthusiasm, conviction, and patience. Not that there was, I met one devotee saying, I'm trying every time. And we hear this, try until we succeed. I give try to my practice, but then again, I get weak. Again, I try from beginning. Again, something happened. Again, I try. I lost all my patience now. My anarthas coming on my way, troubling me, not allowing me to chant. And there was one of my friends like 30 years back, 32 years back. We used to go together in temple. His problem was whenever he start chant, whenever something happens, some accident happens to him. So he was giving a trial. He stopped chanting for a week. The whole week goes very nice, smooth. But then he's getting restless because, you know, we need to chant every day 16 rounds. After a week, when he start his round, he get accident. Then next day he try, something else happen. Third day he try, something else happen. When he gave up chanting, nothing happened. Then he gave up for 2 weeks, not chanting. And I used to ask him, what's happening? Are you chanting? No. Why? No, I'm busy. I said, but you have to chant. We go together to temple. Don't you know this is our principle to chant every day 16 rounds? Yes, but okay, I will think about this. 2 weeks not chanting, nothing happened. Then he starts chanting one round, a roof fall in the house. And then he revealed to me this after some while, experiencing something. And then he revealed that every time when I chant, something happens. I don't feel like chanting because all these negative things happens to me when I start chanting. I said, then that means Harinam is at fault. Don't we hear Mangal Bhavan Amangal Hari? Harinam is the embodiment of all auspiciousness. How can be inauspiciousness in chanting Harinam? He said, because I'm going through all this. I said, this is not Harinam, this is your anarthas. They are not allowing you to chant. They are coming on your way to disturb with something which you not even expected that's happening to you. Sometimes we don't expect some things. We just come with the flow. We don't even expect, oh, this thing will happen in my life. But then it happens. Later we lament, or later we feel joy or lament. But something comes. What is this? Prarabdhas. But when this prarabdha comes on the way, in some form or the other, then doesn't mean we have to stop our practices. Harinam is not disturbing us. Hari Nam is saving us. Is the anarthas, unwanted habits, which happen in many, many lifetimes, coming on our way, especially when we start our spiritual life, is good in one sense. Something was in a backlog, coming, giving some troubles and getting cleared up. It's good in one sense. Something has come up, disturbing. It's good it came. Because now I know I have some knowledge. Now I'm chanting and I can overcome this. Otherwise, many people, they go to depression. Many people, they just leave their body. They commit suicide because no knowledge. Anarthas comes in some way or the other. It can be any form. It can come in any form. And then you just go. But in all times, never giving up chanting Harinam. But this boy, he gave up chanting. I don't know now where is he, but was a very nice person. But this was the anarthas. Every time he take his mala in his hand and chant one round, something happens to him. Devotees got confused. What is this? When he chant, only then this going through. When he don't chant, everything is fine. Is Krishna at fault? Is Harinam at fault? There is so much and so much and so much from previous life that's coming on his way and disturbing him, not allowing him to do this. So we insisted him so much. Don't stop. Keep it on. Keep it going. Keep it going. But then that need association. Utsa, nishchat, dharyat. Enthusiasm, conviction and patience can also only come with association. Cannot be without association. So these are enemies of the mind. So to fight with enemies, we need very strong weapon. What weapon we need? Nuclear bomb. Nothing can be big than that. Oh yes, Corona is big than that. We don't need any weapon to destroy a country. Bio weapon. Just destroy the economy of the country and country is finished. Oh. Harinam is like strong weapon, the best means of repentance, atonement, the best means to serve Krishna, the best means to practice Krishna consciousness, and Harinam is the only goal of the life. And Harinam is only Nam Gokul Mohotsav Te Krishna, is the festival of Brajavasis. Harinam is the one who is taking care of the residents of Braj, the inhabitants of Braj, from separation from Krishna. Krishna left them. Harinam didn't leave them. Krishna disappeared from Ras Leela, but Krishna Nam stayed with the gopis. Krishna Nam cannot disappear. The gopi geet, gopis are singing and they are glorifying Krishna Nam. So you see, comparatively, Krishna can go to Mathura and Dwarika, but Krishna Nam, there's a promise of Krishna. I will come back. Very soon I will come back. And even he wanted to come back, but not happening. Demons were there. He don't want to come back and trouble Brajvasis. So, as a saying, the stone on his heart, with heavy heart, he's outside of Braj, leaving behind his loved ones, and taking care of them, day and night thinking of them, crying and weeping, cannot come back. But Krishna Nam stayed with them, with Brajvasis, and taking care of them, looking after them nicely. Brajvasis surviving because of Krishna Nam. So in so many ways, Krishna Nam is helping the Brajvasis. Krishna can kill demons, but Krishna Nam can change the demons. Nam is not killing demons. Krishna is killing demons. Krishna killing Bhutna, Agasur, Bakasur, Arishtasur, Ravan, Kumbhakaran, Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksh, killing them. But Krishna Nam not killing Jagai Madhai. Krishna Nam changing Jagai Madhai. Changing the propensity to do any sin. There was not any sin which they have not ever performed in their life. And not one time, hundreds, thousands of times. Every kind of sins. The best rogues of Navdeep, Jagai and Madhai, even while staying in Dham. But when they got mercy of Mahaprabhu, they changed. And Mahaprabhu asked, will you do those sins again? What they said? Ar nare bap. Ar nare bap. Not again. Oh, enough. You touch my ears. Enough. Never again. So Krishna Nam changed them. Chand Kaji broke Mridanga, destroyed Sankirtan. But Krishna Nam didn't kill Chand Kaji. Who was Chand Kaji in Krishna Leela? Who was Chand Kaji? Radha Sundari? Kamsa? Not Duryodhan? Yeah, Kamsa. Krishna killed Kamsa. But Kamsa came as Chand Kaji in the pastime of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu didn't kill Chand Kaji, but changed him. And Chand Kaji later on started, he took shelter of Harinam and chanting Harinam. Became an object of worship of all the Vaishnavas in Navadvipdham. Even now, the Samadhi of Chand Kaji is there. And Muslims also go there. Yeah, Muslims also go there. And Hindus also go there. Means Vaishnavas also go there. And Hindus also go there. Without any discrimination. Muslims also go there because Chand Kaji is Muslim. But Vaishnavas also go and pray there. In Parikrama, pay obeisance to the Samadhi. With the potency of Harinam. Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bo Hare Krishna.